Good morning, children. Children, today we are going to start a new lesson, that is the golden bucket. I hope you all have watched the animated video of this lesson. Now, in this video, I'll explain the lesson to you. But before that, there is an activity given on page number 46. Help Mr. Sahu reach the bush to pick berries. So, you have to do this activity on your own. You have to help this man named Mr. Sahu to reach the berries. Place a jungle. Time, one summer day. Characters, John, mother, old man. John has been picking berries. His bucket is full and he is going back home. He sees an old man with a bucket. Old man, have you found any berries, my boy? John, my bucket is full. See. Old man, you have been lucky. Look into my bucket. John, why? It is empty. Old man, I have not seen a single berry today. John, I will show you where to find some. Come with me. Old man, I can walk no further. I'm very tired. John, you can have my berries, sir. So, it is a scene of a jungle on a summer day. So, John is a boy who picks berries and fills his bucket with them. And now he is going back to his home. Now on his way back home, he sees an old man with a bucket. Can you see, children? John and the old man. So John sees an old man with a bucket. Now both John and old man are talking to each other. The old man asks John if he has found any berries. So John shows him his bucket and says that his bucket is full. Now the old man shows his empty bucket to John. And then John asks him why his bucket is empty. So, the old man says that he hasn't seen a single berry today. So, John asks the old man to come with him so that the old man could also get some berries. But the old man refuses to go with John and says that he is very tired and cannot walk. Now when John hears that the old man is tired, what does he do? He offers him his berries. So out of kindness, John offers his berries to the old man. Old man, do you not sell your berries? John, yes, but I can find more. Here, sir, take them. Old man, thank you, my boy. You're very kind. I will take your bucket. You may have mine. They exchange buckets. John, but your bucket is new, sir. Old man, that does not matter. Now I must rest for a while. The old man sits under a tree and seems to sleep. John looks for berries. Soon his mother comes looking for him. Now children, the old man asks John whether he will not sell his berries. So John says that he will find more berries and then he gives his berries to the old man.
And now what does the old man do? He thanks John for his kindness and then tells John to exchange buckets. So both of them exchange their buckets. And now John has the old man's bucket and the old man has John's bucket. Then after exchanging the bucket, the old man sits under a tree to take some rest. Soon, his mother comes looking for him. Mother, John, why are you so late? Where are your berries? John, I gave them away to that old man there. Mother, I'm sorry you did that. I wanted to sell the berries today. I wanted the money to buy your school books. John, the poor old man could not find any berries, Mother. Mother, then I'm glad you gave him yours. So now, after some time, John's mother comes looking for John. Now both John and his mother are talking to each other. John's mother asks him about the berries and why he is so late. So John tells his mother that he has given the berries to the old man. After listening to this, John's mother tells him that she wanted to sell the berries so that she can get some money to buy his school books. Now John tells his mother the reason behind giving his berries to the old man. John says that he has given away his berries to the poor old man because he could not find any berries. Now see children, John is telling his mother the reason why he gave his berries to the old man. Why did he give away his berries to the old man? Because the poor old man could not find any berries. Now after listening to this, his mother says that she is very happy. Why is the mother happy now? Because his son has helped the old man. So the mother is happy because her son has done a good thing. He has helped an old man. John, he gave me his bucket. Look, it is new, Mother. John, this bucket is made of gold. I will wake him up and give it back. John, yes, wake him up and give it back. Now children, John shows his mother the bucket that the old man gave him. And when his mother sees it, she tells John that the bucket is made of gold. And children, do you know what gold is? It is a very expensive metal. So now, both John and his mother decides to return the bucket to the old man. The old man stands and his cloak falls. John and his mother see a beautiful fairy. So children, when they go near the old man stands and what happens? His cloak falls. Now, children, cloak is a type of a loose coat without sleeves. Okay? So cloak is what? It is a type of a, or you can say it is a piece of a clothing. So what happens when they go near the old man? The old man stands up and his cloak falls. And what did the mother and John see? They see a beautiful fairy. So now the old man turned into a beautiful fairy.
Fairy, the golden bucket is yours, my boy. It will bring you books and clothes and food. It will always give you what you need. It is a magic bucket. And now, goodbye.
Goodbye.
The fairy flies away. Mother, oh my boy, see what your kind heart has done for you. A golden bucket. Now, fairy is speaking to John and telling him that the golden bucket is John's. And what is the bucket about? It is a magic bucket. And it will give John whatever he needs. And then after saying all this, the fairy flies away. And John's mother tells him that he has got this golden bucket because of John's kind and helping nature. So children, from this story, we learned that we should help the poor and needy people. And if we will do good to others, it will come back to us. So what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is, do good, have good. I hope you have understood the story. Thank you, children.